What's up internet, I am Manish from rebellionrider.com and in this video we will learn what are VARRAYs in Oracle database. VARRAY is an important topic because it is seen that generally there is always a question on it in certification exam. In order to minimize any confusion, we will first take a brief and quick look at intro of VARRAYs collection. So let's cut to the chase and start the tutorial. VARRAYs, which is an acronym of variable sized arrays, were introduced in Oracle 8i back in 1998 as a modified format of nested table. The major modification can be seen in storage orientation. There are no noticeable changes in the implementation, but their storage orientation is completely different than the nested tables. Unlike nested table, which requires an external table for its storage, VARRAYs are stored in line with their parent record as row value in the parent table. It means no more need of store as clause. Thank God, what a relief. No unnecessary IOs and on top of that, increased performance. As I mentioned, the implementation of a VARRAY is going to be the same as nested table. Thus, I highly suggest you to go through the previous tutorial on how to create nested table. Link is on your screen as well as in the description. That being said, let's move ahead and check out the syntax of VARRAYs type collection in Oracle database. VARRAYs, similar to nested tables, are persistent type of collection, which means they can be created as database object that can be saved for later use or as a member of PL SQL block. First, let's see the syntax for creating VARRAYs as database object. Apart from few changes, the syntax is similar to the nested table. Let's check out those changes. As we are creating a type, thus we used create type statement, which has an optional clause or replace in between these two keywords. This clause looks for the type with the same name. If it finds any, then it changes its definition according to the statement, otherwise it creates one for you. Then there is type name, which can be anything you want, followed by another keyword is. Then we have keyword VARRAY or reserved phrase varying array. You can use whichever you feel comfortable with. I personally like VARRAY, short and simple. The purpose of writing the VARRAY is to tell the compiler what type of collection you are creating. Then we have the size limit. Oh wait, I think I forgot to tell you that unlike nested table, VARRAYs are bounded form of collection, and that is why we have size limit here, which is something you will not find in nested table. By bounded, I mean you have to decide how many elements you want to store in your collection while declaring it. Whereas in nested table, which is unbounded type of collection, there is no upper cap on number of elements. Then we have keyword of, followed by that we have to specify the type of elements which you want your collection to hold. This could be primitive data type or user defined data type. This is the syntax for creating VARRAYs as database object. Now let's take a look at another syntax. As you can see, both the syntax are same, except this time we don't have keyword create, because here we are declaring a VARRAY as a member of PL SQL block and not creating it as a database object. The scope of the VARRAY which is declared inside a PL SQL block is limited to the block in which it is created. Also remember, similar to nested table, we can declare VARRAY only in the declaration section of PL SQL block. That is the syntax for creating a PL SQL VARRAY type collection in Oracle database. Now you will ask, is it possible to change the size limit of a VARRAY after its declaration? The answer to this question is, of course it is possible. You can modify the size limit of your VARRAY whenever you want by using alter type TTL statement. And here is the syntax for modifying the size limit of a VARRAY. After writing the clause alter type, you have to specify the name of your VARRAY which you want to modify. Thereafter, you have to write a clause modify limit. This clause informs the compiler that user wants to modify the limit. Followed by that, you have to specify an integer, which will be the new size limit of your VARRAY. Try to make sure that this integer is greater than the current maximum number of elements in the VARRAY. At the end, we have two important clauses, invalidate and cascade. These clauses will help you in dealing with the dependent objects. such as if you decide to go with the invalidate, it will invalidate all the dependent objects without any checking mechanism. And if you decided to go with the cascade, then the changes will propagate to dependent types and table. That is all about how you can modify the size limit of the VRA. What about if you want to delete it completely from your database? To find out how to drop a VRA, check out the blog. This is a quick introduction of PL/SQL VRA. You can always head over to my blog for more in-depth knowledge on the topic. Link is in the description. Hope you learned something new. If so, then hit the like button and make sure to subscribe. You can also help others in learning as well as help me and my channel in growing by sharing this video. This is the PL/SQL tutorial 54 on collection type VRAs. Thanks for watching. I am Manish from RebellionRider.com.